Hello students, welcome to this fourth lecture of the topic or the chapter 3-dimensional geometry. In this particular lecture we are going to study projection of line segment joining two points on a line. So if we have been given two points and if we join these two points to get a line segment, what is its projection on a given line? So there is a given line and its direction cosines is available to us. Its direction cosines are L, M, N. So in that case, what is the projection of this line segment on this given line? So projection means that from both the end points of the line segment, we will draw perpendiculars on this given line. This is what is called projection in normal life also. It is not necessary that these two are in the same plane. They may be in different planes, but still we can find the projection. That is, if this is a line segment and there is a line, so the projection of this upper line segment from elbow to this tip of the finger to this lower line simply means that we draw a perpendicular from this tip on this line and from this elbow on this line. The small portion will be the projection of this line segment on this line. So let us find that length. If we consider that these are the points P and Q, and we consider that their projection are P dash and Q dash, so what is P dash Q dash? If we draw a line parallel to this given line through P, then we know that this angle is theta, which is right now not available to us. Can we get that angle theta? So that this line is having direction cosine LMN, same, and this particular line segment has direction ratio x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. And if you remember in the previous lecture, we also studied that if a line segment PQ is given, then its direction cosine L dash, M dash and n dash can be obtained if their direction ratios are x2 minus x1 upon the length of this PQ. Let us write z1 also here and z2 also here, as we are studying about three-dimensional geometry. So there are three coordinates. Root over sigma of x2 minus x1 square. Just go to the previous lecture, you will find it. M dash is y2 minus y1 by root over sigma of x2 minus x1 square, and n dash is z2 minus z1 by root over sigma of x2 minus x1 square. Now let me also tell you what is this sigma of x2 minus x1 square. This is actually x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square plus z2 minus z1 square. And what is the distance of this line segment PQ? So if you will observe, if we take a square root of this and we take a square root of this, then this is nothing but the distance formula between the points P and Q. So this is representing the length PQ actually, right? So now this denominator in each of these are nothing but the line segment PQ, its length. Now if we talk about the projection P dash Q dash, then P dash Q dash is actually PQ cos theta. In the lecture number 2 we studied about direction cosines, and there we studied about the way of finding the angle between two lines whose direction cosines are given. So if we consider that this and this, these two lines are actually having direction cosines LMN and L dash, M dash, N dash, then can we get cos theta? Yeah, we can get from the lecture number 2. This cos theta is actually L into L dash plus M into M dash plus N into N dash. This is actually the cos theta value. Now I have to erase something in order to write more of it. So after understanding that what is L dash, M dash, N dash, you can say that P dash, Q dash is actually PQ, L, L dash plus M, M dash plus N, N dash. Now if we multiply PQ with each of them, we can write L into L dash PQ plus M into M dash PQ plus N into N dash PQ. Can you tell me what is L dash PQ? Yes, of course, if you have seen the process right now, L dash was x2 minus x1 by root over sigma of x2 minus x1 square. And what is root over sigma of x2 minus x1 square? This is nothing but the line segment PQ, its length. So this is x2 minus x1 upon PQ. If you multiply PQ with L dash, you get PQ into L dash is equal to x2 minus x1. Right guys, you have understood it very correctly. So PQ into L dash is actually x2 minus x1. So this is L into x2 minus x1. Now you can also write about M dash PQ, which will be y2 minus y1. M into y2 minus y1 plus N into z2 minus z1. So finally, if we have been given 2 points x1, y1, z1 and x2, y2, z2, and there is a line whose direction cosine is L, M, N, then the projection of this line segment on this line will be given like this. So finally, let me write the formula for you. What is the formula for us is, and don't forget to put the modulus sign in the end, because projection means the length, which has to be positive. So x2 minus x1 L dash, sorry L, y2 minus y1 M, plus z2 minus z1 N. This is the projection P dash Q dash, and in the end just put a modulus sign. In case you get it negative, don't forget to make it positive. Right students? So if I have given you that the given line is the x-axis, do you know the direction cosines of x-axis? Yes, it is L equal to 1, N equal to 0, N equal to 0. If you remember this, and if you don't remember, just go to the second lecture of direction cosines. This is for x-axis. So in that case, what is the projection of a line segment PQ on the x-axis? According to this formula, it will be simply P dash Q dash is equal to x2 minus x1 mod, because other terms are 0, because M is 0, N is 0, whereas L is 1. Similarly, projection on y-axis is y2 minus y1. Projection on z-axis is z2 minus z1. So we can say the component of the line segment PQ along x, y and z can be given by x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1 and z2 minus z1, which we knew earlier also. So after doing this, let us consider a few very simple cases over here. Like if you have been given direction ratio of a line ABC. This is the direction ratio of a line. What do you understand by direction ratio? That is, with respect to direction cosines, they give a same constant. That is, they are proportional. That is, they are equal to K. Can you tell me what is K over here? So basically, if you have seen this lecture and the previous lectures, you can understand that ABC are actually the direction ratios which are the component of a particular line segment along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. And if you see this, A is actually L into K, B is actually M into K and C is actually N into K. So this L is K cos alpha, this is K cos beta, this is K cos gamma, where alpha, beta are the direction angles with x axis, y axis and z axis. So A is actually the component along the x axis of the line segment. B is actually the component of the line segment along y axis. And C is the component along the z axis of the line segment. And it is written as k cos alpha, k cos beta and k cos gamma. So you can say that if this is a line segment PQ whose components along x, y, z are A, B, C, then this k is nothing but actually the length of this line segment PQ. Then only you will say that suppose if this is the x-axis and there is an angle alpha between the line segment and the x-axis, then the projection of PQ along the x-axis will be given by PQ cos alpha. And what is the projection? That is A, which is also equal to K cos alpha. So finally, this PQ is same as K. Similarly, you can do for y-axis also, students. So you can also learn this very important technique that if the direction ratios of a line are given, then what is the constant which is obtained after dividing the direction ratio with the direction cosines of the line? That constant is basically the length of the line segment which is giving the component A, B and C along the coordinate axis. So this is the lecture for you students, and I will come in the next lecture, and in that lecture we will use this concept, and also we will find out the distance of a point from a line. So for this lecture, thank you students.